Welcome to the show presented by VDG Sports. I'm your host, Vince Douglas Gregory. I have an amazing show for you. However, I might have to warn you. I'm definitely going to warn you that I didn't come up with this. I was just put to this. I did not come up with this. This was just something that was put to me and I said, okay, I'll do it. I will do it. And no, I'm not talking about having my button, top button, unbuttoned. No. I'm not talking about that. What I'm talking about is, what do you call a quarterback who cries after a game? Seriously, what do you call a quarterback who cries after a game? And how many points do you get for winning a soccer match? Is it one or two? I got a long answer and I got a short answer. I'm gonna start with the long answer first and we will get to the short answer sooner or later. And then you'll wonder why this was even a question. But hey, I was put to this. I was put to this. And what happens to a star player in football who teams get relegated? First off, it's not that football that you're thinking. It's the other football. It's the football that you actually play with your feet. And when you touch it with your hand, it's a handball and it's unacceptable. It is not acceptable on any levels, on any terms. But hey, I was put up to this. Last but not least, can an NBA ref have long hair? I tried looking for the answer. I tried searching for the answer, and I'm just gonna tell you what I came up with. I'm gonna tell you what I came up with. Eventually, we'll get there, eventually. Save the best for last, right? Save the best for last, correct? Or that's what they say. That's what they say, so that's what we are going to go with for now. Okay. What do you call a quarterback who cries after a game? A winner? A champion? One who threw more touchdowns than interceptions? One who's considered to be the greatest of all time? Or short form, GOAT? First off, why is this quarterback crying? Why? Is the quarterback happy? Is the quarterback sad? Is the quarterback a little bit distraught? Is he all there? Is he suffering from a concussion? I mean, I got questions. I got questions. I need answers to answer your question. For all I know, his head could be hurting. Seriously. You ever had one of those headaches where it just hurt so bad? Everything you do, every time you move, every time you blink your eye, you just get this throbbing and it's just throbbing and it's throbbing. You just want it to go away. You just want it to go Betty Bye Bye. You just want to be able to function without this headache. It'll make you cry too. It will make you cry too. How do we know that he's not suffering from that? How do we know that he is not suffering from the headache that just won't go away? Some of you might call it a migraine, but I'm gonna call it a headache. I'm gonna call it a headache because I wanna stay consistent and I don't wanna use big words like migraine. I don't wanna use big words like migraine that we will have to look up and get the definition for. And I don't want to be throwing out more definitions. Again, you've already showed me how you handle definitions. You already showed me how you handle definitions. But let's not get it twisted. Let's not get it twisted. And shout out to you know who. You know who. It's okay to cry. It's okay to cry, especially after a game. It can be tears of joy. Yeah, we won. We got 5, 6, 7 more games to go, but we won this game. So I'm gonna be crying 5 or 6, 7 more times because we're gonna win those games too. What do you do when you lose?
I won't cry.
Or you could be crying after a loss. You could be crying after taking an L. You could be crying after holding the L. Why? Because the L burned. The L hurts. The L ain't something what you used to carrying around. It's heavy. That's too much weight. That is too much weight. Lifting all those weights and working out and doing all those exercises so you don't have to hold and carry the L, it still doesn't help. It still does not help. That could be the reason. That could be the reason. I mean, I got answers. I can throw answers after answers after answers, but hey, I need more questions or more in-depth questions to get to the end game of this. If I was in that position, would I cry after a game? I don't know. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. After championship, after holding the trophy, after winning, after being named the MVP, possibly, possibly. But I can't guarantee. I can't guarantee that because, hey, who knows what's gonna happen in the future? I don't play a psychic on TV, and I don't have a crystal ball in front of me. And if I did, I wouldn't waste my vision on that. And if I had wishes, I wouldn't waste a wish on that. We all know that the first wish you make is to have more wishes. And then after that, you go for broke. Then after that, you make wishes like you drink water. And if you're not drinking water every day, you should. If you're not drinking water every day, then you should. Now, hopefully, that is enough intel. That is enough information for you to make your own decision on what to call a quarterback. Basically, you probably should call him by his name. Last name first or first name last, regardless, say his name and don't mispronounce it. Because he got friends. He got friends in high places. He's got friends in low places, and they will find you. It's a small world after all. They will find you. And I'm not speaking from experience, and I will blink multiple times to let you know that I'm okay, and I'm not being put up to this. I'm not being put up to this. No, no, no. But how many points do you get? How many points do you get for winning a football game? Football equals soccer. Soccer equals football. Football equals the thing that you play with your feet when you touch it with your hands. It is a handball. A handball. I just wanted to do my hands like an X, but it's a handball. You don't want to do that because you'll get a card. And this is not the cards that you want either. This isn't the business cards. This isn't the transaction card. This isn't the credit card. This is one of those cards that can let you know if you can be aggressive or let you know that you can continue to be a spectator. Continue to be a spectator. And I would make jokes about why don't you know how many points does it take or how many points do you get for winning a soccer game. And I'm gonna say soccer so you can understand and not get confused when I say football. But since you want to know, and since we're here, and since it was asked, you get 3 points. You get 3 points. That's the long answer. The short answer to, is it 1 or 2? No, it's not. 1 or 2? No, it's not. This isn't hockey. This isn't hockey. I'm sure watching so many sports and having so many sports in front of you and it just morphed into each other and you thought soccer was hockey. And hockey was soccer, because hockey is something that you do just like soccer, but you do it on ice and there's a puck and you got sticks and you can hit, you can fight, you can
do whatever you want to do. It's your world and the rest of us living in it. Assuming you're in hockey and assuming you understand hockey and pay attention, because it's one or two people. And you mixing up the amount of points for football and hockey, that leads me to believe that you really didn't know what soccer slash football is. I don't know how long it's been 3 points, but one or two, I got something else that I have to tell you. Make sure you're sitting down for this. I have something else that I have to tell you, and make sure you are sitting down for this, because it's gonna blow your mind. Your mind is gonna go poof. But stay with me now. Stay with me now. In soccer, in football, yes, the football, the game can end in a tie and you get points. You get a point. I know, right? The game can end in a tie and you will get a point. So instead of getting the three, instead of taking all of the points, you will drop 2 points and you will get at least 1 point. If you get 0-0, 1-1, 2-2, 3-3, 4-4, 5-5, 6-6, you get it? A draw is the same equal amount of points that you have with the other opposing team. You get 1 point. You get one. So in that sense, you probably should have understood the whole hockey thing. However, in hockey, they still eventually have a winner. You go to overtime and then you still get a winner. So that I'm not going to try to make that make sense. I'm not going to try to make that make sense, because it's not really a tie in that sport. But in soccer, football, that's when you get the 1 point. You get the 1 point when both teams have the equal amount of points at the end of the match. And the end of the match, that includes the first half plus extra time, the second half plus extra time, and that is it. There are occasions where it will go to penalties, but that's when it's in a tournament, that's when it's a competition, that's when you have to have a winner of the match to progress on to the next step, to the next level. But and even in that setting, or even when it comes to that, you don't really get a point here or there, because you are progressing on. I know it's a lot to try to remember. I know it's a lot to try to understand. That's why I try warning you. I try warning you to tell you to sit down. You don't need to be standing up. You don't need to be standing up, and please keep the sharp objects to yourself. Hands and feet to yourself. Just relax. It's okay. It's gonna be all right. Football is soccer. Soccer is football. You say it a couple of more times and then you actually start believing it. Say it a couple of more times after that, then you actually know it to be true. Say it a couple of more times after that, I'm going to tell you to stop, because you're going a little bit too far. Nobody likes an overachiever. Don't be the smartest guy in the room. Don't be the smartest guy in the room. Nothing but bad things happen and occur after that. Trust me. And I'm not speaking from experience. So what happens to a star player that gets his team relegated? Well, he really doesn't get his team relegated. If he's a star player, he's probably the only star player on the team. Hence, the team got relegated. Because if there is more than one star on the team and the team gets relegated, then they're bigger questions. There are more important questions that need to be asked, and this one is just in a valley. You need to go and reach for the summit of the mountain. You need to go to the top. all the way up. All the way up. Don't start from the bottom up. Mm-mm. Go top bottom. Go top bottom. And wondering why a star player, or what would happen to a star player when a team gets relegated. Well, he won't get relegated. He won't be on that team. He's probably going to leave. He's probably going to go somewhere else. They're probably going to get rid of him because they can't afford to keep him in the lower league that they're going to. Oh yeah, by the way, side note. I'm sure, and I'm assuming, but I'm sure that you know what relegation means, or getting relegated, because you put it and it's in the question. But for those who have zero clue and they're here for the ref and they're here for everything else and they're here for all things that's not football, relegation is when you are in one league that's higher up and you don't qualify, get enough points to stay in that league, and you go down to the next lower tier, and you're there and you got to fight your way back up to that league that you just left and accumulate so many points and possibly play in a tournament, however the structure is. But relegation is that. You go from one higher league to a lower league because you just wasn't good enough. You just didn't have what it takes to compete, or some bad things occurred, some bad things happened, some people jumped ship, there was some injuries, and jumping ship mean left or leave. I know, I have to explain these things sometime, but that's what I'm here for. That is what I'm here for, to explain the unexplainable, to just let you know what it is, because what it is ain't always real, and you need that real hard truth. You need that real fact. You need that real, the real, along with the new, but this ain't the time, this ain't the place to talk about the new, so we're just gonna stick to the real. But the star player is gonna do, there's multiple things, but there are bigger questions than this. The star player is going to leave, or he's going to stay and help the team get back up. But to put this all on his shoulders, I'm going to say that is not plausible. You can put some negotiable facts in there. You can have some hidden truths. You can just throw a bunch of stuff to the wall and hope it stick. Throw some things to the wall and hope it makes sense. Throw it up. Now, if he didn't perform to the level that he is at, if he didn't perform the way he usually performs, and he just came down levels and played well under his normal playing performance, then okay, sure, blame him, but still, there are more players on the team depending on him to lift everybody up and sing, to lift everybody up and say, come with me, I'm gonna keep you up. That's just letting me know that the rest of the team ain't that good either. Cause if one person out of 20 something is performing not up to their level, not up to their standard, then what are the other players doing? Then what are the other players doing? In this sport, one is just not going to do it. One isn't just going to do it. You're going to need multiple players to perform badly or not be at a higher level to get relegated and not stay up. Because if you got a couple of stars, if you got a couple of peeps in there that can just ball or do a little something, or can just do a little two-step here and there, then you good, you golden, you fine. Unless the organization is ran like a business, and the business motto is to just go along to get along and make that money, fine, okay. And they have people that really don't know what they're doing operating things. They have people in charge that don't know that football is soccer and soccer is football, and they assume that it's two different sports. Then you probably have problems. Then I would understand your plight. Then I would understand the question. Then I'll understand all this other stuff, and I can just put it in a box for you, put a ribbon on it under the tree or in your hands because it's your birthday. But I don't need to see that suit. I don't need to see the suit, because I'll just give you some free advice. If that's the case, be prepared. This ain't rock bottom. Be prepared for the worst. So when the worst doesn't occur and the worst don't happen, you got reason to party. You got reason to throw it up. You got reason to dance. You got reason to do what it do. Why? Because it didn't happen. Why? Who knows? Why? Why ask why? Just go ahead and look down and press that I believe button. And if you don't have one, you should create one. If you don't know how to create one, just imagine and use mine. Just use mine. It's okay. Caring is sharing. Sharing is caring. I'm good with that. I am good with that. So putting it all on the star player for the team to get relegated, it's a fallacy within a fallacy, and I'm not going to explain fallacies for you because we ain't here for that. But just know this, it ain't all his fault. It ain't his fault. Did he do that? It ain't his fault. Did he do that? Not all of it. Some of it. It takes a team effort. The team itself performed below the level and below the standard that will keep them up in a higher tier league, and therefore they're going down to their standards, the lower tier, and maybe in that lower tier they'll be above that and they can come right back up. If not, they will stay in that lower tier until they meet the standards or be basically better than those standards, and then require promotion, and then they'll go up. But other than that, unless the manager's not qualified, and I'm being nice, that could be the case. And if that's the case, then you know what to do. Don't wait too long. Go ahead and pop that balloon. Now, can an NBA ref, yes, referee, have long hair? Look. I thought about this long and hard. I took time to investigate this. I took a couple of weeks. The weeks turned into months. The months turned into about a year, and then the year kind of just like went and it turned back into weeks again. And now we're here, back to the start, back to the front. And I looked at video, I looked at some historical documents, I asked some imaginary friends, I asked some other people. I even sent out an email. Yes, an email. That thing like a letter that you type out and that you press send and it goes to an inbox, kind of like the mail, but digitally to multiple people. If you do an all kind of thing, that. I'm not gonna continue to explain, but I'll leave it at that. I did the investigation. I put in the work. I asked people. I did research. I looked at video. I went back to the Malice in the Palace days. I went back to the 60s, the 70s. I didn't go into the 50s. If you know, you know. The 90s, the knots, the 10s, even present day. And this might shock you. This might surprise you, but it's okay. It is okay. I am here. You can stand up on this one. You can stand up, put your chest out, jump up and down, do bicycle kicks. I would suggest you do the Running Man, but about 99% of you don't know what the Running Man is, and I'm not going to explain that either. Just do the research like I did the research on this. Can an NBA referee, the guy with the cool outfit on, that runs around, that makes sure that everybody is doing what they supposed to do on both teams, and if there is a foul, you call the foul. If there is some egregious play, you call the foul. If there's something that occurs or happens that needs to be dealt with, you do it because you are the authority. Hey, you're the authority. Now, if somebody was put in a position of authority and they had super duper long hair, a long scruffy beard, and they was not, I repeat, not well groomed. And this is just me painting a vivid picture. This is just me just making something make sense. And I'm not suggesting that this is true. I'm not saying that this has occurred. So pump your brakes on that one. That I'm not saying. However, if there was somebody in a position of authority that wasn't properly or well groomed, would you be able to take direction, take instruction from said person if they was a stranger and you didn't know who they were and this was one of your first times meeting them and maybe you met them a few other times but you don't know them like that? You don't know them by name. You only know them by ref. You only know them by, hey, I didn't do that. Hey, why are you calling that? Hey. So basically, the name could be hey. Or the other word that you can put in before hey. But this is still a family show. And this is still a family program. Therefore, I can't utilize that type of language. And I can't say earmuffs. Because if I say earmuffs like that, I'm just the earmuff police. I don't get paid for that. I do not get paid to say earmuffs or be the earmuffs police. And plus, I don't want to intrude on your freedoms like that. I don't. So I'm gonna keep it clean. I'm gonna keep it within the realm of, hey, you got all that going on. And this person in charge, this person of authority, not well groomed, you don't know who they are. They are making calls and doing things that can affect how you are at work and how you operate and how you get down and how you make your money. Would you be cool with that? Would you be cool with that? Would that be all right? I'm not asking for me. I'm asking for you. I'm asking for the fan. I'm asking for the person who wants to know that, or peeps that want to know, can an NBA ref have long hair? I mean, it seems like it's a straightforward answer. It seems like the answer would have came up like immediately. Maybe it did. Maybe I misread it. Or maybe I didn't read it at all, because when I got to the answer, I had already checked out. When I got to the answer, I already checked out. Because if he wanna wear long hair, by golly gee Willie, let him wear long hair. Will I still respect him? Of course I will. Would I still let him do what he do? Of course I would. Do I, and have I, seen any with long hair operate or ref a game? I want to maintain being a truth teller. That's the one thing that I would like to pride myself on, especially when I have to, and especially when it's dependent upon me to do so, which is pretty much all the time, 24/7, 365, and 365 is the number of days, even though we know with the leap year and all that stuff, but I don't want to include any of that because it just caused confusions when you say the 365 and do the 1/4 for the 0.25, and it's just too much work. It's just too much work. I have not. I personally have not. Through my lifetime and my experience, I have not experienced that. I have not seen it. It's almost like chasing Bigfoot. Have you caught him yet? Nah. Does he exist? Maybe. Have you found him? I don't know. The Loch Ness Monster. There's pictures. Have we seen him since? People tracking him? Yeah. People caught him yet? Nah. It's like that. Does it exist? Yeah. Have I seen it? No. Am I looking for it? No. It's that simple. It is that simple. I mean, if I were to see this, and you know me, I'm the sharing is caring Care Bear, Care Bear stare. I'm that dude. So I will definitely share the wealth. Meaning, I will definitely show them pictures. I will definitely keep those receipts. Me showing those pictures, keeping those receipts, doing the Care Bear stare, and doing all these other things that me and caring is sharing, because I am here for you. Big Boy Vince is here for you. So when I get my hands on this, you will definitely have this available to you as well. Unless this does not exist and I haven't found any evidence one way or the other to say this does or does not exist, so I'm going to formulate a hypothesis, I'm going to gather the data and the intel, I'm going to run a few tests, and from there I'm going to give you my results, only for it to be ready and available to be tested again, assuming we are formulating another hypothesis. But as of now, currently ATM, I can't say one way or the other. I just know I ain't never seen it before. I ain't never seen the $1 million before either, but I know it exists. I ain't never seen the gold coin, but I know it exists. So you gonna have to trust your instincts, you're gonna have to trust your gut feelings, or you're gonna have to write the NBA and ask this question. Write the NBA and hopefully somebody will get back to you, or better yet, you don't even have to do the NBA. You can just do the Refs Association and you can ask the refs, or you can just go and do interviews, or go and reach out and ask refs, and they will let you know. And they will have the correct answer, and they will be able to tell you 1,000,000% whether or not that it's okay to have long hair or but I can't say one way or the other, and I'm not on the fence. I'm not on the fence. I'm just jumping up and down, straddling the line and saying, you can't get me, you can't get me, you can't get me. See? I told you I was gonna make that interesting, even though, please, please, never again, never again. I was forced to do this. You can tell by the multiple blinkings. You can tell by me blinking at the rate that I'm blinking. Help, help.
Sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.